Chef Ramsay has seen enough of this service. Customers are unhappy. And there's chaos in the kitchen. So he decides to take a break from the madness and check out the food storage.
Look at all this food in here.
And what he finds is an outrageous amount of food for a failing restaurant.
How much produce is in this fridge? Trays and trays of produce. Look, they've put the fresh one at the front, and at the back, you've got the squidgy one. Marinated skirt. Oh, tilapia. That is what you call dry chicken. That's more chicken. There must be thousands and thousands of dollars worth of food here. If their cash flow is in the this is a big reason why.
Thank you very much. Have a good night, guys.
After observing dinner service, Chef Ramsay now knows that Mojito's problems are not just confined to a bad relationship.
I don't argue for no reason.
And subpar food.
He'll never come here again.
In fact, Mojito's is in much worse shape than he thought.
Right, let's start off with tonight's dinner service. Or shall I say a disservice. Customers pissed off. Dishes been returned. If each and every one of you want this restaurant to work, you all have to reach for a standard. Whether you're serving food, whether you're cooking food, or whether you're sending food. At the end of service, I pop downstairs. Who does the purchasing in here? Who buys the fish, the meat, and the vegetables?
Me. Mashallah.
Stay there. Stay there. Let me just show you something.
Right now, I'm pretty nervous because I don't know what's going to happen.
Just take that out for me, please. Just bring the whole tray out for me.
I don't know what's going to happen. I don't know what to expect. I'm scared.
Mojito's is over $300,000 in debt.
I am amazed.
What Chef Ramsay found in the basement is one of the reasons why.
Oh, no. I don't even want to look.
Thank you. Okay.
I was speechless. How can Marcelo allow something like this to happen?
I've never seen such waste in my entire life. You've got enough food down there to serve a banquet of 5,000. There's seven of these down there. Seven.
I don't know if I'm gonna kill Eduardo first or I'm gonna kill myself first.
This is rapidly shutting down the restaurant. I've got some work to do and I've got to get out of there, guys. That makes me feel sick.
I'm the owner, and this is my kitchen. This is my place. I should be the one taking control of the situation.
Chef Ramsay uncovered many problems at Mojito's. But for this restaurant to ever work properly, he has to understand the issues between Marcelo and Cotta. So he spends the morning with both of them.
Okay. All I've seen so far is a bossy, angry little princess. The restaurant's suffering on the back of both of you constantly hurting each other. He does it to you, you do it to him, and it's so sad. And it's affecting everybody else down the line.
It's embarrassing.
Take me back 7 years when you got married.
We are together all time. Everybody say, you are the perfect couple. We decide to have a baby. So we started to do fertilization process.
The IVF.
And nothing happened.
I was putting everything into it.
Mm-hmm.
And I was willing to sacrifice and to do and go through the treatment, but it was no support from him. Like, while I was on the treatment, injecting myself, he was out partying with friends. I was being left alone. That's when I'm like, no, not happening. You're not coming home to me at 7 o'clock in the morning. I'm your wife.
Yeah.
So that's when everything started going wrong.
How did the marriage break down?
She go to Florida for 1.5 years in Miami.
Did she meet somebody else in Miami? Did she meet another man in Miami? Yeah.
I took a trip. During the trip, I decided that I was going to leave him. You're not making me happy. I'm not making you happy. Go your way, I'll go my way.
Do you think it's time that one of you says goodbye to the business and give each other space?
I think we'll be very healthy. I want cut off of this business. She don't have any idea of how run a business. She don't do nothing.
How important is the business for you?
It's everything for me. The person that I was married to, that person doesn't exist anymore. He's gone. And I have to move on. And that's what I'm doing. And I take the loss of my marriage. Mm-hmm. And I think that's the price that I have to pay for my business. So I'm taking care of my business because that's all I have left. Whatever it takes, I'll go to the end. Until I feel that there's nothing else that I can do.
I've got a plan. I need to see you like it was 4.5, 5 years ago. You know, funny, confident, and no bickering.
I'm committed.
Okay, committed. Thank you. Commit. Stand strong. Okay. Thank you.
Marcelo and I, if we don't find a way to communicate, if we don't find a way to get to an agreement, the restaurant is gonna go down the drain. But Marcelo really drives me crazy. I don't think it's gonna work ever.
While Cata and Marcelo have both lost their passion for each other, Chef Ramsay wants to know if they still have their passion for the food.
One thing I haven't seen since I've been here is you two working together. So that's what exactly we're gonna do now. With all these ingredients in front of you, cook me something authentic, something Cuban, and do it together.
Oh gosh, are we gonna be able to do this?
Hey, no arguing. Yes?
We can be together at the kitchen.
I'll make the shrimp with a pineapple sauce.
Okay, let me do the fricassee.
Marcelo wanted to make chicken, but I wanted to do my shrimp. So we started cooking two dishes instead of one.
Very quiet in here. Are we okay?
Everything good.
Everything's good. Is this dish done together?
We're doing two dishes.
Now, I want to see you two Muppets work together. One dish. Oh my God.
That's not gonna happen.
Okay. Don't freak, just keep moving.
Okay.
One dish?
Two. 50-50.
Oh, unbelievable. Okay. Chicken with potatoes. Whose idea was it to do the shrimp? Whose was it?
Me. Mm-hmm. Simple flavors. I think I did a much better job than Marcelo.
I like that.
Nice.
That's nice. What is that?
Chicken fricassee.
Presentation, it's not as attractive as a shrimp, clearly. Not blow me away, it's mediocre. The shrimp is the dish I'd love to pay for in a local Cuban restaurant. We'll do that as a special tonight, yes?
Yeah, it makes me feel wonderful that my dish has been chosen for a little special by Chef Ramsay. An honor.
Okay, good. Now do me one more favor. Out together through the door. See if you can just manage walking out together.
While Chef Ramsay works on another special with Chef Eduardo.
Right, let's do something together, yes?
Something special is also happening out in the dining room.
Marcelo.
Cata and Marcelo are communicating.
I wanted to ask you if you want to switch tonight. I'll be in the kitchen. You want to be here? When you come out here, you stay up front. You just, like, follow the lead. Works. We gotta talk to Chef Ramsay if he allows us to do that. If he allows it, I'll go into the kitchen.
The people at the kitchen gonna run out. With her attitude, with her... She's a nightmare.
Coming up on Kitchen Nightmares.
I'm the boss here. Remember who I am.
Kata's on the warpath in the kitchen.
If I wanna scream, I can do it.
And nothing?
He's standing there doing nothing.
Or nobody.
I'll do it myself.
Will get in her way.
But you have to listen to me. Everything is a disaster.
And a dining room led by Marcelo is a circus.
Don't bounce around like a monkey.
Will this soap opera have a happy ending, or will mojitos go up in flames?
Marcelo, get out of the kitchen. Get out of the kitchen.
That's next on Kitchen Nightmares. Chef Ramsay's plan for tonight's dinner service features his garlic chicken and cotta shrimp with mango salsa.
Tonight's gonna be a lot better than we had last night, yes?
Yes.
But cotta has a plan of her own.
Chef Ramsay, we're gonna be switching places. Marcelo and I are gonna be in the kitchen starting. He's gonna be front house.
I mean, that sounds great. Who came to that decision?
We both did, yes.
Woo! Round of applause. That's amazing. Wow. Everybody's happy. So I want fast, efficient service, hot food, and more importantly, you've got to show me that you can handle those small changes. Expedite, host, serve, cook. Woo! Let's go, yeah? Yeah.
Welcome to Mojito.
Thank you.
Don't point
it. I'm definitely really nervous about tonight's dinner service.
I don't think Marcelo does well in the front of the house.
Okay, don't bounce around like a monkey, yeah? Walk in the dining room.
As patrons enter the restaurant...
Welcome to Mojito.
You will find the specials over here.
Kata takes the helm in the kitchen.
While you work for me, I'm your boss. So you're here and fryer. This is your section.
I can definitely handle pressure in the back of the house.
And it's more chicken than vegetables.
And I know I'm going to do a much better work than Marcelo.
How you doing, guys?
We have a couple of specials tonight.
It's a lemon and garlic garden chicken.
We also have two jumbo grilled shrimp with a tropical salsa.
We'll take one of those.
Okay. You want the chicken special?
Thank you so much.
Here we go, guys. First order, yes?
Guacamole and cheese, beef empanadas, and then we're going to have a garlic chicken, pescado marinero, ropavilla, churrasco de carne. I'll tell you what to throw the churrasco. And one order of empanadas, one chicken, one beef. Let me have another jumbo shrimp and one guacamole.
No, two chicken specials.
Thank you, team. Another order of the jumbo shrimp special.
Well done.
Tonight's dinner service is off to a good start.
Good.
Kata has control of the kitchen.
One chicken.
Thank you so much.
And customers are enjoying the specials.
I don't know why, but it feels better tonight. Why?
Way better.
Why?
Catalina is awesome in the kitchen.
Two guacamole and chips, one tropical shrimp.
Marcelo's actually better in the front because it's less stress on him.
Señor, thank you so much.
So he's better in the front, she's better in the kitchen?
Yeah, I believe so.
Three more chickens in total. Yeah.
You look so good and composed back here. That's how you do it.
Hello.
Holler back, baby. Holler back.
Thank you, baby. All the love.
This restaurant is still chaotic, but there's a massive significant difference. Kata can handle pressure 1,000 times better than Marcelo, and the good news is the specials are flying out.
While the new specials are a big hit with the diners,
really good.
The original menu is striking out.
I have to get something else, just a very strange taste to it.
Coming up.
What's wrong?
He didn't like the... his has a strange taste.
Strange taste.
Yes.
Okay, let's go, guys. Pick up.
Kata, this steak was his strange taste. Can I have ropavilla instead?
Yes.
It's on the window.
Come on, Kata, wake up.
Keep it respectful. Remember who I am. Don't give me attitude, because I don't need to give you attitude. I'm the boss, like it or not. You have to listen to me.
You waiting for your sides, though, right?
Yes, he's getting
it.
It's not worth it. What is it for?
Wait, let me have the ticket. What's the mess for the ticket? I'm feeling a lot of pressure. There's lost tickets. There's food coming out wrong. Everything is a disaster. And Chef Ramsay is watching us.
I need a container for that ticket. It's an ice bucket. I need a spike in the kitchen because we're losing tickets.
My God, those sandwiches are not ready yet?
Almost done.
When we get busy, Kata loses herself. She becomes very confused.
We have one order of tropical shrimp.
That went out already.
Everything went out?
She doesn't know what really is going on.
Wait, mommy, hold on.
It's chaos.